you, and before we get started, for those of you who don't know, this is Mr. Fryer's last high school graduation, so we could give him a round of applause and thank him for his years of service. Good morning, Superintendent D'Angelo, Board of Education, administrators, faculty, staff, parents, and our graduates. 43 years ago, Millbrook High School held its first graduation ceremony here on this parcel of land in Millbrook. Doubtless, it was an exciting day for that group of students, their parents, grandparents, siblings, other family and friends, as well as that first group of teachers who taught here and the first administrators who worked here. And you can bet that those seniors back then were just as excited and just as happy as all of you are now to get their degrees. They, as you, had their whole lives ahead of them, and their future looked as bright and shiny as yours does. But what they also had that you do not have is the ability to go about seeking that future quietly and somewhat anonymously. They could go to college or not, seek work immediately or not, move to another state or not, and the whole world wasn't able to learn their news immediately. They could get married, have children, raise a family, without any pictures at all being broadcast nationwide. Seniors returning for their 10-year reunion could have completely reinvented themselves by the time of that reunion, and the world became the wiser only as that reunion was taking place. You don't have that same ability to go about inventing the business of your lives quietly. Social media has arrived. You attended high school in the dawn of a new age, where news from 5 minutes ago is already ancient history. We want to know now. We need to hear every little tidbit that's going on in the world immediately. We feel left out if we don't know what's happening before we are told it by our friends. So you need to understand right now, before you leave here today, what that impact will be on you as you move forward in your lives and in your careers. Those revealing pictures from that college party, the sarcastic tweets that were made during class, the likes on Facebook for things which are politically polarizing, they all seem like so much fun at the time. And they were, but I'm here to tell you that they will have consequences in that bright, shiny future which is ahead of you. One thing each of you owns is your reputation. Don't let others steal it from you through carelessness or neglect on your part. Let what you put out to the world focus instead on maintaining the relationships and the friendships that you have built through your years at Millbrook, as well as everything that you achieve. The class of 2014 has achieved significant accomplishments, especially during this past year. We had a wonderful production of Peter Pan, where actually two of our senior actresses flew through the air. The volleyball team went to the New York State Championships. Both boys and girls basketball and lacrosse teams went on to sectional playoffs. We had a successful band trip and Model UN trip, where you received many compliments for your leadership. Most notably this year, for the first time ever, Millbrook High School began a senior internship program, the very first in the county. I'm thrilled to report, by all accounts, it was a huge success. Its pilot year will be remembered for the many glowing recommendations that came from the businesses that sponsored students, as well as the overwhelming enthusiasm that poured in from both parents and students alike. Mr. Fiorenza and Mrs. Hotowing were consistently raving about your insights, your growth, and your maturity. And we all know it takes a lot to impress Mr. Fiorenza. The high praise received by students resulted in no less than 10 job offers. Those are amazing results for a brand new program. Millbrook seniors of the class of 2014, you have set a very high bar for others to follow. So, as you turn your tassels to a new position today, as you move on to college, the service, or perhaps to a job, please be very aware of what you want others to know about you. Plan your lives carefully with regard to what social media will say about you, and focus on maintaining those bonds that you have built at your time in Millbrook. Set your sights on lofty goals and then achieve those goals, always mindful that the support from your former teachers, staff, fellow graduates will always be here. The class of 2014 has accomplished some amazing things. Decide now that when you come back for your 10-year reunion, you will have even greater achievements to share with your dear friends and classmates who have been such an important part of your life. Best wishes, graduates. I'd like to now introduce Superintendent D'Angelo for welcoming remarks.
I would like to welcome the members of the Millbrook Senior Class, the Board of Education, Ms. Intrary, Ms. Roberts, faculty and staff, parents, family, and friends to the commencement exercise for the class of 2014. I extend my sincere thanks to the senior class and Ms. Intrary for allowing me to be part of the ceremony. As Ms. Intrary said, this class was the first class to experience a senior internship. It was a very unique experience. And as they went out, I think it's very important that they either found a career that they really loved or a career that maybe they didn't love so much and they needed to look at other endeavors. Now, I know today is about the graduates, but I'm going to talk a little bit about a young man who grew up in a community in Western New York, in Avon, New York, horse country, very similar, very parallel to this community. So in 1970, Sister Janice asked a fourth grade class in Avon, New York to write what they wanted to be when they grew up. And I wrote an essay saying I wanted to be a teacher. Sister Janice, we had 44 students in our class, and you could see the love and the connection she made with all of us, and that she enjoyed every minute of every day. And I saw that, and I wanted to experience that in my life. So I was very proud of my essay. I think I got an A on it. I took it home, and my parents said, "You don't want to be a teacher." Now, I need to fill you in on something. I'm Philip Jr. My father is Philip Sr. He's a dentist, and he loved his job just as much and wanted me to follow in his footsteps. So I went to college, applied to dental schools, got into dental schools, and actually went to the same dental school he went to. Did well, but I knew it wasn't for me. That wasn't the same feeling that I knew my father had. And I kept thinking of Sister Janice, and to this day I still think of her, and I'm in communication with her. So one day I went to my father and I said, "Dad, I don't want to be a dentist. I know you love it, but I don't. I want to be a teacher. I want to do what I love. I want to follow my passion." So I became a teacher, a coach, an advisor. And in 1993, in February of that year, I was named Teacher of the Year, Coach of the Year, and became a father for the first time. In my mind, that validated my desires and my hopes and my dreams. And I'm sharing this story because I want the 85 graduates that are sitting to my left and right to try to have a career that they love, where they'll jump out of bed in the morning, where they'll want to go to work, where they know they're going to make a difference, and most of all, where they get self-satisfaction. So what I'm going to challenge these 85 wonderful young adults sitting to my left and right, find what you love. Give it your all. Enjoy what you are doing and make a difference in other people's lives, as well as giving yourself great satisfaction. Oftentimes, it's appropriate to wish people good luck. Luck implies chance. I'm going to give you my wishes to do well. Your future is not based on chance. You have the skills and abilities to accomplish great things, and I know that you will. So do well, have fun, enjoy your life, and make a difference. So congratulations to these 85 wonderful young people. Congratulations to the parents, family, and friends who have supported them from kindergarten to this point. And please enjoy the rest of the ceremony. It's about these wonderful young people. That's what education is all about.
To now introduce New York State Senator Terry Gibson to give his welcoming remarks.
Well, good morning, everyone, to the faculty and staff and parents and friends and certainly the graduates. Thank you so much for letting me share in this very important day with you. I hope that you will take a minute, graduates, to look out at this audience that's here sitting in the hot sun to share this moment with you. Look at that audience there and never forget the faces of those people. Your family and the community here in Millbrook, the business owners in Millbrook, the people of New York State have spent the last 12 years making a significant investment in your education. A significant investment and significant sacrifices they have made so that you could get here to this day. So on behalf of New York State and the New York State Senate, I do want to thank you, because I know that we are all relieved that you made it, and we are expecting great things from you now, that we have made that investment. No pressure. Today is your day. Today is your day, and you should celebrate it to the fullest. You have earned the right to celebrate. You have earned the right to be proud that you have reached this significant moment in your education and in your life. But I have some good news for you. Tomorrow will also be your day. And the day after that, and the day after that, and the day after that will be your day too. And it will be up to you to decide how you want to take advantage of those days. I hope that as you travel down life's path, that you will be flexible, that you will be open to new ideas, that you will be willing to take new paths in life, explore new things, and that you will seek out advice from lots of different people. And use that advice that you gather to decide what you think is right and what is right for you. Ladies and gentlemen, sitting before you today are future lawyers and doctors, business owners, nurses, teachers. There might even be a senator. There might even be a future president. Why not? Why not? Why could that not be possible? Hopefully, there's people sitting here today that have new ideas, or certainly soon will have new ideas about creating new services and new products that will eventually employ hundreds of new people here in New York State. I hope that you will rise to that challenge. This is an exciting time to be graduating high school. We need new leaders. We need new energy. We need new people to go out there and take control of all of the issues that are facing us today. There are a lot of challenges, but I am sure the education you have received here at Millbrook has prepared you for that. Take it one day at a time. Life is full of a lot of small steps. Don't get too far ahead of yourself. Decide what you want to do tomorrow, and whatever you're doing, do the very best that you can. Hard work will open doors that you cannot possibly imagine exist right now. Stick to that, and you'll do well. Congratulations again. We are so proud of you. Have a great day. Thank you.
I would now like to congratulate and invite our salutatorian, Jessica O'Callaghan, to please come forward and give her address.
So even though I've always hated graduation speeches, I'll start off by saying hello and welcome parents, faculty, students, administrators, grandparents, second cousins twice removed, oh, and obviously the guy passing out in the back. My apologies, but even I can't escape generic introductions, so touche, Mr. Fio, censoring me obviously got the crowd's attention. So now that my delivery is off to a good start, I'll encourage any of you to interrupt if I cannot break this monotonous streak, but fingers crossed I can, and the majority of you can sit still for the next 5 minutes without the thought of, oh God, there goes another Albert Einstein or Mark Twain quote crossing your mind. Not that theoretic physics or literary satires don't relate, but let's just say my generation has other ways of getting ahead. But moving on, as far-fetched as it may seem, I, world-class tryhard, or in slang terms, squid, have sat down a couple times to brainstorm on the big MHS. Now, for some of you, high school might have seemed like a playground, and for others, like myself, not so much, but I'll just throw out some ideas that came to mind at the time. So high school, number one. Rummaging through CVS for Clarisil serums. Number two, reading dystopian novels, including but never limited to Anthem, Fahrenheit 451, and Brave New World. Number three, sniffing Expo markers during Jeopardy in chemistry class, mostly Chris DeMann. And lastly, number four, reminding your desk how versatile you can be with profanity. Well, I'm sorry, but I don't know how writing phrases beginning with the letter F will suffice. So, tell me, class, how am I supposed to conjure up a synopsis of our time in high school? How can I sum up our exposure to worldly academia through the New York State Regents, or our commitment to nutrition by rallying for the return of curly fries? I'm sure we're all in agreement here, right? The English language has stopped working, apparently, and your patience with me is running low. So, I could sit down now, right? No? Well, To be frank, high school obviously has its trying moments. Surprising coming from the salutatorian, I know, but just because I did well in school doesn't mean I necessarily enjoyed myself, even though I really did, Mom. And don't worry, I'm not up here to say that the pantsuit shouldn't be an integral part of the code of conduct. But I'm also not here to say that we necessarily liked each other or that our membership in this class will serve as some great unifying force after we graduate. Rather, I encourage you to take a look at someone sitting to your right or left. Now, can you reflect on your time here and say that, in the grand scheme of things, them not being there one day will adversely affect you? And before you answer, I want to clarify that growing up, we obviously shared many similar experiences. We learned how to drive together, battle the fat stages together, some longer than others, and even dabble in rebellion during nap time together, as much as we regretted it later on. But still, I advise you not to lament on the assumption that we are one of the same just because of a number we'll be remembered for. Or that we took the time to get to know each other, when in reality, I'm sure many of you don't even know that some of your classmates are skilled botanists or tend to have accidents in Italian restaurants, not to name names. But in all seriousness, what does any of that matter? Yes, we as people like to find commonalities amongst each other, but I think that we strongly undermine our value as individuals, especially in high school. You see, in here we were taught how to care about things we normally wouldn't. Perfect example, did any of you really care about having your own definition of the term monster? No, obviously not, especially not in comparison to all of the other first world problems we had to deal with as freshmen. But the point is, today isn't about celebrating how our class did this or that collectively. No, today is a day that you can step back and reflect on what it is you accomplished after coming here, and more importantly, if you found yourself along the way. Not that you should be satisfied with where you are, because I know I'm not, but try and look at where you started, when you filed into the auditorium 4 short years ago with the rest of us. And even if you didn't achieve what you set out to, like that orientation PowerPoint all about growing up and becoming adults had hoped, I'm telling you now that you have the rest of your lives to figure out what it is you want out of them. Because it isn't about who had the highest GPA in high school, or who was going to the college with the lowest acceptance rate, or kissed the most you-know-what. None of that separates us from one another. With all of the answers we're expected to have, like which concentration, of which career, of which major, of which subject we want to study for the next 4 years of our lives, I'd say that the decisions we make out of ignorance is what sets us apart. Like, evidently, some of us couldn't even figure out whether to A, comply with Ms. Herring's wishes to write 3 thematics, or B, slam our heads through a wall. So how are we supposed to know that voluntarily signing up to get mind raped, aka take the SAT, was a good idea? Well, other than being reminded 2 years in advance, kudos to Miss Grady and Naviance, we didn't, and that's all right. Because the success of our decisions is defined by how we perceive them. And what we need to remember is that the turning points in our lives aren't made slouched over a desk or trying to adopt what others encourage us to. They're made bumping Kedrick and cruising down 82, sinking our lacrosse cleats into the turf field as we shower in buckets of rain, and my personal favorite, taking flying lessons with Mr. T and moving vehicles. Simply put, they're made when we enjoy ourselves, and that's exactly what we as a class have to take away from our time here. For we aren't expected to live one way, we're meant to pursue what we love and are passionate about, and especially find ourselves when no one else knows how. So congratulations, I love you all dearly, and I will see you on the other side.
At this time, if Mr. Fiorenzo would please come forward to give the commencement address.
Welcome, Mr. D'Angelo, Dr. Ackerman, Ms. Intrary, Ms. Roberts, the BOE, colleagues, family, friends, and of course, the Millbrook senior class of 2014, most of whom, unfortunately for them, are my former students. First, I'd like to thank Mr. Tringali. Originally, 2 speakers were scheduled, but for time considerations, 1 was decided upon, and he graciously deferred to me. There's an irony here, and it goes back to when we were 2 of the chaperones on the school trip to England 2 summers ago. I will always think of us together, two suspicious Americans, let's say it was late at night, as we tried to steal Wi-Fi off of a Starbucks for our iPads. That's all I can divulge. So what do I remember about the class of 2013 and 2014, the school year at Millbrook? It was the first year of the internship program and the many miles me and Mrs. Hotelling walked back and forth between our rooms. It was the year I converted Ms. Intrary to become a fan of Diane Ravitch, our premier educational philosopher, even to the point of going to see her speak one evening this winter. Side note, anyone interested in knowing the truth about education in America today should read Ravitch's book, Reign of Error. That's Reign of Error, published by Knopf Books. It will be the last year I speak with Mr. Fryer when we both agree that Stravinsky is, in fact, the greatest classical composer. It will be the last year I pester, haunt, and torture Dr. Ackerman for more money in the budget for books for my students. And this year, she became my BFF. Secrecy, and I sort of kept my word. And I will never forget, I think it was called Big Blue Day. I'm not sure why. Picture, if you will, eight students, Mr. Lavity, me, and my claustrophobia, trapped in the high school elevator on a hot day for hours. Actually, it was 10 minutes. Let's just say it's not an elevator anymore, but the evil cube of death. As for my students, Dan Outwater, who took incredibly long to return my Pat Metheny and John Coltrane DVDs. Jessica O'Callaghan, who still has not returned my book, The Hours. Lydia Kevra, you know what I'm about to say, Lydia. There are no homies in Millbrook. Clay, yes, who's danced on the last day of classes, sort of an arthritic octogenarian in the throes of a seizure, has scarred me forever. Let's just say he was moving to the rhythms, and I quote, Tom freaking Petty. Allison Marty and Emily King and their distorted pictures of themselves on my board. It's about the only time my board is ever used. Journey Campbell, not for the many books she read, but because when she entered the cafetorium, it was the cue that my lunch duty was over. Ah, lunch duty, a most joyous time of day, watching teenagers eat and say things no adult should ever hear. Summer Boardman, who brought cookies in that she baked at Babette's for her presentation. Chloe Nelson, who brought in a cake she baked for her presentation. Dylan Harrell and Every Granger, whose back-to-back internship presentations about computer viruses and the problems with our water supply left me curled in a fetal position in the corner of my room, crying, waiting for the apocalypse to come. The end is nigh. Now we come to the time of the speech when I share memorable words of advice accumulated through wisdom and experience and all those great books I've read as an English teacher. So here it goes. The song Let It Go from Frozen, not cool. The song Happy from Despicable Me 2, cool. Breaking Bad, cool. Mad Men, not cool. The Yankees, still cool. The Mets, yeah, okay, well. Higher taxes on my Central Hudson bill, not cool. Higher taxes to take proper, timely care of returning vets from Iraq and Afghanistan, that's cool. Fox News, CNN, MSNBC, not cool. The Daily Show and the Colbert Report, very cool. The Miami Heat trio of LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Bosh, not cool. The San Antonio Spurs trio of Tim Duncan, Manu Ginobili, and Tony Parker, cool. Republicans in Congress, not cool. Democrats in Congress, yeah, not cool either. Midterms, finals, Common Core, ELA 8, Regents, APs, SLOs, SRIs, PSATs, SATs, ACTs, not cool. Officially graduating from Millbrook High School today to begin the next phase of your life, cool. I'm pandering, by the way. So what do I hope for your future? Some of you will be venture capitalists. Some will have a conscience and care about people. Some of you will find your soulmate. Some will end like Hamlet and Ophelia. Some of you will read great literature, and some of you will never read a book again. opting instead for trash on the internet from your phone while sitting on the toilet. Some of you will listen to good music with something to say, and some of you will listen to Taylor Swift. I do not wish you a successful life. I wish you a meaningful one. You should do some things that have nothing to do with personal gain. I know of many successful people whose lives are meaningless. Kim and Kanye and Justin Bieber and Miley Cyrus and Honey Boo Boo. Oh God, I have more on the list, but I'm just getting nauseous naming those first few. Life is not a selfie. There is more to this world than you. Drop your ego. Don't live only for yourself and your pleasures. I would be remiss if I didn't include a quote from The Who, and I believe most of you know my opinion of the greatest rock band ever. The more we learn, the less we believe to be true. The more we prove, the more remains to be proved. This is what education should be, whether in or out of school. Everything you learn should lead to more questions, not answers. Everything you know should lead you to something you don't know. You should never get to the end when it comes to knowledge. Soon, when the ceremony ends, you will be happy and you can clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. I do not know what that means, but at this point, does it matter? Thank you and be well.
Good morning to Mr. D'Angelo, Ms. Centuri, Mrs. Roberts, the Board of Education, family, friends, and the class of 2014, because we've already heard that 50 times. So, as we walk to collect our diplomas and move on with our lives, we wear the traditional cap and gown. This dress not only represents the accomplishments we have reached, but also stands as a way to unify us. We are the class of 2014 of Millbrook High School, but more than that, we are a student body who has faced losses and championships together. The turnout at volleyball state finals and football, lacrosse, and basketball sectional games presented us with school spirit and the drive for success. The cap and gowns show a unity in dress, a unity in our class, and they also show that girls can wear appropriately laced clothes. As we sit through these speeches, wishing everyone's were shorter so we can just go to parties and eat, we have to face the facts. Let's be honest, we're all failures. Let me finish. Okay. Not in the sense that we got bad grades or did the wrong thing, but because we ignored opportunities. As adolescents in a small community, there were times we took the easy way out. We knew what we could get away with and often did the littlest amount of work possible. In college, work, the military, or wherever we may end up after today, I encourage you, my class, to strive for success. Stop worrying about what everyone else thinks, accomplish more than what you're expected to, and make the most of every situation that comes your way. So sitting here at graduation, we're really not failures at all. We just need to learn that sometimes success will take effort, and we are all above mediocrity if we try. One comforting outlook is to remember that you are never alone. No matter what the situation is or how distraught you may be, there is someone out there that is facing a similar issue. So when you're stressed or on the verge of tears or about to give up, think about the others who feel the way you do. There's probably even someone within your vicinity dealing with the same issues or struggles, whatever. Okay. Look at them and say, well, hey, this person is able to get through it all and succeed, so why can't I? Or adversely, think of how that person may give up and have failed. Then say to yourself, well, I can obviously do better. Think of your high school class and how we all manage to succeed in one form or another. While we move on with our lives and push away all these high school memories, we will occasionally look back at our classmates. We'll Facebook creep past crushes and friends, see if Juddy is still rocking his haircut, check if Allison is starring on Broadway yet, and see if Evie has found a way to end world suffering. We will continue to follow Amanda through her volleyball career and maybe one day hear Matt's trumpet blaring through the radio. More than anything, don't be the person that everyone else will look at like, geez, what happened? Prove to yourself and everyone else that you can be better, that you can be better, and will be better. Lastly, I thank the parents and teachers who are the ones that truly got us here. You cheered for us in sports, applauded during the play, and actually encouraged us to learn things. So congratulations to the class of 2014. I wish you all the very best.
I'll be leaving my mark like initials carved in an old oak tree. You wait and see. Maybe I'll write like 20.
shall paint like Van Gogh. You're the common gold, I don't know, but I'm ready to start, cause I know in my heart I wanna do something that matters, say something different, something that sets the whole world on its ear. I wanna do something better with the time I've been given.
Presentation of diplomas. I'd like to invite Mr. Thomas M. Hurley, President of the Board of Education, Mr. John M. Rudy, Vice President, Board of the Education, to please come forward to present the diplomas. Ethan Wilksey and Christopher DeMann, NHS Vice President and Treasurer, to read the names, assisted by Mrs. Watts and Mr. Tringali, our senior class advisors.
Veronica Aaron Peterson, valedictorian. Jessica Ann O'Callaghan, salutatorian. Yes! Mackenzie Ryan Alexander. David B. Baldwin. Carlton P. Bates III. Summer Ray Boardman. Christopher James Bonadonna. Sojourn Sky Campbell. Henry Cardinal. Gregory Carnivali. Carolyn Rose Cena. Ethan Joshua Cohen. Maggie Mae McGinnis Cristiano. Amanda Marie Critelli. Catherine Ann Cummings. Joseph Daly. Christopher Daniel DeMann. Julianne Desjardins. Eric M. Diani. James Joseph Dignan. Joseph W. DiGregorio. Austin D. Dingy. Audrey K. M. Dizan. Silvana Alezi. Julia Catherine Galantic. Mason Charles Garnett. Kevin A. Gerasi. Taylor Elizabeth Goodwill. Kenneth Aaron Graham. Evelyn Marie Granger. Madison Brianne Coyne Hartsfield. Shauna Renee Foy Henschel. Dylan Thomas Harrell. Ryer Lavity. Judith Emily Homa. Stephen Thomas Hurley. Devon T. Jackson. Nevi Nicole Khan. Brittany Ann Keenan. Lydia Ann Kevra. Emily Jennifer King.
Marlena M. Mancini. Matthew Walter Martell. Allison Ann Marty. Jeremy Mayer. Leah Nicole Mazzella. Jesse Roger Mercurio III. Jessica Marie Mayan. Yeah! Skylar Reed Meyer. Joseph Andrew Mayans. James Joseph Moore. Adam Ford Munderbach. Chloe Lee Nelson. Kyle Thomas O'Brien. David Benjamin Oliveira. Audrey Rose Wimay. Daniel James Outwater. Jason James Pelk. Richard Bradford Pitts. Joshua Philip Pouncey. Tyler Avery Prater. Nicholas A. Railer. Donald C. Rowe Jr. Maxwell Paul Shaba. Emily Rose Shanks. Rory Ethan Shoemaker. Justin Donald Simmons. Clayton J. Swallow. Oscar Sosa. Alexandra Mary Straley. Thomas Kelly Sweck. Michael Sweeney. Cassandra Salowitz. Natalie Tobo Romero. Michael August Van Hagen. Shelby Marie Whalen. Stacy Rose Wadera. Marissa P. Williams. Sarah Elizabeth Williams. Ethan D. Wiltsey. Rachel Mackenzie Wolford. Alexandra Ann Worthington.
Can we have one final applause for our class of 2014? I'd now like to invite Mr. D'Angelo, Superintendent of Schools, to come up to present formally the class.
Mr. Hurley and members of the Board of Education, based on the authority delegated to me by the Board of Regents of the State of New York, it is my honor and privilege to certify that each of these individuals presented to you have completed all of their necessary course requirements and New York State examinations. Therefore, at this time, I would like all of the graduates to please move your tassel from the position on the right to the position on the left, as you now are officially graduates of the Millbrook Central School District. Congratulations.
I would now like to invite Mrs. Grady and Mrs. Pettit to come up, our guidance counselors, who will process the graduates out to throw their caps.